Good morning everyone. In our previous video we have finished the chapter number 1 of accountancy. Now in this video I am going to start the chapter number 2 of accountancy, which name is basic terms of accounting. So there are so many terms in accounting which are used frequently in business organization. So let's start with our first term. I have noted down here the first term is transactions. Now what are transactions? Transactions kya hote hain bhai? The transactions are the economic events of a business. Economic events, or you can say the economic activities. I have told you in business studies that what are economic activities? Activities which are undertaken for money. So these are the economic activities which bring change in the financial position of a business. So these are the economic activities which bring change in the financial position of a business. Economic activities. Activities which bring change in financial position of a company. Financial position means assets, liabilities and capital of a company. Now there are some characteristics of transactions. Characteristics of transactions. The very first is economic activity. Okay, all transactions which are of financial nature are known as transactions of business. The second one is there are two types. Number one, external, and number two, internal. There are two types of transaction, external and internal. External transaction are those transaction which are taken place between the business and outside the business, means third party. Suppose purchase goods for cash. So it takes place between the business and between the supplier, which is the outsider of the business. These are known as external transaction. And internal transaction are those transactions which are taking place within the business organization. So for example, depreciation provided on machine. What is depreciation? Decrease in the value of asset. So it takes place within the organization. So it is known as internal transaction. There are two types of transaction, external and internal. The third one is measured in terms of money. Measured in terms of money. It means that business transaction should be capable of measured in terms of money. All those transactions which cannot be measured in terms of money cannot be treated as business transaction. The fourth one is effect on assets, liabilities and capital of business. Okay, so these are the four characteristics of every business transaction. It should be economic activity, two types of transaction, external, internal. Third is measured in terms of money, and fourth is it affect on asset, liability and capital of the business. Now take some example of transactions. Examples. Number one is started business with cash. रुपीज 5 लाख. सपोज मिस्टर एक्स ने बिजनेस स्टार्ट किया और कितने अमाउंट से? 5 लाख रुपीज से. सेकंड, देन ही परचेज गुड्स फॉर कैश रुपीज 3 लाख. फिर उसके बाद उसने क्या किया? गुड्स मार्केट से खरीदे, तो इट इज एन एक्सटर्नल ट्रांजेक्शन फॉर रुपीज 3 लाख. देन ही सोल्ड गुड्स फॉर रुपीज 3,60,000. उसने फिर गुड्स सोल्ड किए 3,60,000 के, और वी कैन टेक हियर 3,80,000. नाउ नेक्स्ट पॉइंट इज पेड रेंट ऑफ बिजनेस बिल्डिंग और गोडाउन, पेड रेंट ₹10,000. सो दीज आर द बिजनेस ट्रांजेक्शन बिकॉज दीज आर मेजर्ड इन टर्म्स ऑफ मनी. सो ट्रांजेक्शन आर द इकोनॉमिक एक्टिविटीज विच मेक्स चेंजेस इन द फाइनेंशियल पोजिशन ऑफ अ बिजनेस. नाउ सेकेंड टर्म इज, सेकेंड टर्म इज इवेंट. वॉट इज इवेंट? इवेंट मीन्स कॉन्सिक्वेंस और रिजल्ट, रिजल्ट ऑफ ट्रांजेक्शन. The consequence or result of transaction is known as an event of a business. Suppose there are some transactions. Now, what are the effect or result of these transactions on business? Sold good for cash. Sales for ₹3,80,000. If we subtract purchase, purchase for ₹3,00,000 and also paid rent, rent ₹10,000, then the total expense will become ₹3,10,000. Now subtract it from the sales, ₹3,10,000. Sales ₹3,80,000. If we subtract the purchase and rent from the sales, then it remains 70,000 and it will be called our profit. It means that the effect of these transactions will result in profit of ₹70,000. So it is an event for the business organization. Now if we want to find out the closing capital, because Mr. X started business with cash ₹5,00,000, so it is called the opening capital. If we want to find out the closing capital, then how will we find out? Opening capital ₹5,00,000 by which he started the business, plus profit. How much profit? 70,000. So total is 5,70,000. And it is called the closing capital. So what are the consequences of these or result of these transaction? It will result in profit of 70,000 and it will also increase our capital from 5,00,000 to ₹5,70,000. So I have explained two terms, transaction and events.